thought of having this start team make it a beast team. We'd obviously getting yourself on the description below, get yourself to U7 buy, get yourself some cheap, reliable coins, and don't forget to use King with a cheeky 6% off. Right, let's get into the video.
Yo guys, what's going on? King Flipper here, and welcome to another Centurions SBC video. Today we have Nemanja Vidic's Centurion card, which is an 88 rated. I'm not going to go through it too much. The only issue is it's pretty much a plus one on everything to his 87. I think it's only plus two on dribbling, I think he's had. So, card's pretty decent. I did not check his play styles though. That was the only thing I didn't actually check. I've still got him saved up here. So, sorry, it's his passing that's a plus two. Everything else is just not really worth it. Play styles. Does he have more play styles? No. So, he has exactly the same play styles. So, yeah, we'll talk about this. We'll talk about the price differences at the moment about this SBC. But, it's out for a month, which is good. Quite a few segments, so before we get into it, we'll get through the three easy ones, which are pretty much cheapest chips. We start with the Born Legend. It's all rare bronzes. Rare bronzes are still 200 coins by now, which is good to see. So this is 2.2k. You get yourself a rip-off small silver players pack, which I class as a 2.5k reward. And even more of a rip-off, because silvers have gone up in price. You're looking at 350 coins by it now for rare silvers. You can pick them up cheaper for bids, but 350 coins at the moment. Don't really want rare silvers going up in price because of what you get. You only get it's 3.85k to do Rising Star. You get a 3 common gold player pack. Please change that, EA. Keep saying every time. On a loan is all rares. All golds, non-rares. All gold, non-rares. They are 550 coins by it now at the mo. Nice. Obviously because of upgrades and picks and everything like that. So this is 6.05k to do on a loan, which is still not that bad. You do get a loan Centurions. So yeah. And then we get into the important ones, which is the Manchester's Wall to start off with. These are footbin bite now, price of time in this SBC, which has been out for a few hours. Bids and slots will always be cheaper, and don't forget prices do of course fluctuate, especially as it's out for a month and team of the weeks change a lot, so just bear that in mind. So you need a Man United player. Ericsson's the best bet. He's nearly min price to, well, nearly the same price as normal 83s. Team of the Week's minimum one. Go for an 83 rated Team of the Week card because there's a 3k difference at the moment between 83 and an 84. 84 rated team, 984s, 283s to do, and 11 players in squad. 9 of your cheapest 84s at the moment. Obviously, these will fluctuate around. You're looking at 3.3k for 84s. So you've got Moreno, Madison, Gabriel, Mateo, Kula Daddy, Ruben Neves, Bonassa, Ford, and Ilstead. They're 3.3k, as I said, they do fluctuate around, so just bear that in mind. Bwaman, cheapest 83 rated card at the moment, in form, 12.5k. As I said, there's about 2.5 to 3k difference between an 83 and an 84. And Ericsson is 1.3k. He's only 100 coins more than normal 83s at the moment. He's the cheapest Man United player, so yeah. You're looking around 43.5k to do this at the moment, so between 40 and 45k to do an 84 with an in form. You do get a small Prime Electrum Players Pack, which is a 12.5k reward. Then we get to the top notch. Again, another Team of the Week card. Shuck. With an 85 rated team. 287s, 984s. So again, there is a Team of the Week SBC out at the moment. So if you don't have to buy one, you can put an 84 in form, or you can go for an 87 in form, which I've done. Whichever one is kind of cheaper, if you get what I mean. Whatever's closest price difference. So I've gone for the 287s, 984s. Alberto is the cheapest 87 rated card at the moment. He's 30k. Maggle, 87s are 18.5k each at the moment. So there is a 12.5k difference between an 87 in form and an 87 normal card. There is a 12k difference. 3.3k for 84s. 13.4. There's nearly a 12k difference, so it might be better to go for an 84 in form. It just depends on whichever one tickles your fancy or whichever one you need to buy. Because if you've got normal 87, you can throw that in instead. So just do whichever. But 3.3k for 84, so you've got Moreno, De Brits, Martins, Madri, Madison, Gabriel, Mateo, and Kula Daddy. Oh, and Ruben Neves. I always do that. You're looking around 78k, so between 75 and 80k to do an 85 within and form for the top notch. You get a Prime Mix Players Pack, which is 20k reward. So League Legend and 86 rated, both the same requirements, so the only difference is you need a Premier League one for this one. So to do both for an 86 rating with a Prem player, I've used Madison, but you can pick whoever. 587s, 384s and 383s, cheapest way to do it the mo. So you've got Martinez, Modric, Magal, Oberdorf and Bruns at 18.5k each. Your 84s, Madison's one of the cheapest Prem players, Mateo and Kula Daddy at 3.3k. And then you've got Romagnoli, Asabi and Asenio, three of your cheapest 83s, as I said, they're 1.2k each at the mo. So 106k at the mo to do an 86 rated team, so you got to double that. But you're looking between 110k to do an 86 rated team. You get a prime electrum players pack for that one, so 100k again, you got to double it. But you get a premium gold players pack, so both 25k rewards are just slightly different for them 86s. And then we get into an 87 rated squad. Cheapest way to do an 87 rated squad is 588s, 187, 384s, and 283s. So we got Ocean Man, you're looking at 26.5k for 88s. Bernardo Silva, Katoto, Renard, and Oblak. Again, 26.5k at the moment for 88s. They have gone up. Shock. Magal, 18.5k. Mateo, Kula Daddy, and Ruben Efs, 3.3k. And then Hilaire and Ezrubel at 1.2k. So yeah, this is 163k. So you're looking between 160 and 165k at the moment to do an 87 rate squad. That's not cheap. You do get Rare Electrum, which is a 30k reward. Woo. So, yeah, as I was saying, this Vidic card is double the price of his normal card on the market. No. Are you okay, EA? Are you okay? Because no. There is no way you've doubled the price of a card with a plus one on everything apart from his passing. Huh? Huh? To this SBC, unfortunately, guys, 510k. Tradable market, 87 rated one is 250k. It's just stupid. There should be no way he should be double the price because of a plus one. He hasn't got any extra play styles. His only thing that's gone... I mean, I think his shooting went up a couple, but that doesn't really matter. His short passing and long passing was the only thing that was important that went up by two. I just don't get it. You get 117k worth of rewards, but in my opinion, absolutely not worth it 100%. There's much better cards out there, unfortunately, for half a mil. It's a shame. Because I know the Vidic card will be good, but you might as well just buy the tradable one off the market. So, yeah. Let me know in the comments below. Do you agree with me? I'm hoping you've listened to this, and hopefully I have saved you some time and some money and some information about not going near this and just buying his half the price one for his 87, which is just better value for what it is. It's only a minus one on each. So, yeah. If I did, please feel free to drop a thumbs up. It does help the channel and the video. Obviously, if you want to see more SBC videos like this, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Make sure you got that notification bell on so you can keep up to date as soon as I upload these. Apologies. Other than that, I'll see you guys in the next video stream. Take it easy, obviously. Peace.